Now we are going to solve class 5 SOF IMO 2023 to 24 set A question paper, Achiever section, question number 46. Study the given figures carefully and select the correct option. Here we have two figures. The options are A. There are total 3 acute angles inside this figure. As we can see, there are only 2 acute angles in this figure. Therefore, this statement is wrong. B. There are total 10 right angles inside the given figure. As we can see, there are only 4 right angles in this figure. So, this statement is also false. C. There is no obtuse angle in the given figure. As we can see, there are total of 5 obtuse angle in the figure, so this statement is also false. Hence D, none of the above is the correct answer. Achiever section, question number 47. Fill in the blanks and select the correct option. A. The value of this Roman numeral. M is equal to 1000. CM is equal to 900, LXX is equal to 70, IX is equal to 9, which gives us a total of 1979. Now B, in the given number 58,736, the successor of the place value of digit at hundredths place is. The place value of digit at hundredths place is 700 and its successor is 701. C. Rounding off the greatest 6-digit number formed by using the digits 5, 3, 1 and 7, each digit at least once to the nearest 1000 is. The greatest 6-digit formed using 5, 3, 1, 7 is 7,77,531. And rounding off, we get 7,78,000. That leads us to the C option, which is our answer. Achiever section, question number 48. The given line graph shows the number of persons who got jobs in the given years. Study the graph carefully and answer the following questions. A. How many less persons got job in the year 2012 than in 2015 and 2016 together? First, we have to add the number of people who received their jobs in 2015 and 2016. That is 3000 plus 4000. That is 7000. Now, how many less persons got their job in 2012 than in 2015 and 2016? Number of less persons who got their job in the year 2012 than 2015 and 2016 together is 7,000 minus 2,500, that is 4,500. B. If 2 by 5 of the total persons who got their job in the year 2013 are in government sector, then how many persons were recruited in private sector in that year? Total number of persons got job in 2013 is equal to 4,500. Number of persons who got their job in government sector is equal to 2 by 5 into 4,500, which is equal to 1,800. Number of persons recruited in private sector is equal to 4,500 minus 1,800, that is equal to 2,700, which leads us to our answer as D. Achiever section, question number 49. What is the smallest number of squares that must be shaded so that the given figure has a line of symmetry? The first one, this part is symmetrical. If we shade 1, this part will be symmetrical. If we shade 3 and 2, this part will be symmetrical. If we shade 4, then this part will be symmetrical. If we shade 5 and 6, this part will be symmetrical. This part is symmetrical. This part, if we shade 7, then it will be symmetrical. If we shade 7 squares, then this figure will be symmetrical. Similarly, the next figure. So, and in order for this figure to be symmetrical, we have to shade 8 squares. Similarly, in the other figure, we're doing a horizontal symmetry. In order for this figure to become symmetrical, we need 8 squares to be shaded. Similarly, in the other figure, we're gonna do a vertical symmetry, which also has an 8. So in order for this figure to be symmetrical, we need 8 more boxes to be shaded. So since the question has asked the smallest number of squares, so the smallest over here is 7. So our answer is 7. Achiever section, question number 50. Read the following statements about the given figure carefully and state T for true and F for false. A. The shaded decimal part of the given figure is 0.5. Triangle is divided into 16 equal parts. The fraction of shaded parts is 8 by 16, which is equal to 1 by 2, which is also equal to 0.5. Therefore, decimal part is 0.5, so hence statement A is true. B. If 5 more triangles become shaded, then the unshaded fraction of the given figure is 7 by 16. If we shade 5 more triangles, then the number of shaded triangles become 13 by 16. Therefore, the number of unshaded part is 3 by 16, not 7 by 16. So, statement B is false. C. The number of more triangles that must be shaded so that the given figure has 0.75 as the shaded decimal part is 6. If we shade 6 more parts, we get 14 by 16 as a shaded part. The decimal part of 14 by 16 is 0.875. So, statement C is also false, which leads us to the D option. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe. Hit that like button and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye!